At this Congress, we also reported some interim results from our investigator-initiated study combining ibrutinib with a low-dose CpG given intratumorally and local low-dose radiation in patients with indolent lymphoma. We reported data from 13 patients that we've treated thus far. The trial design is really based on some preclinical data suggesting that ibrutinib and intratumoral CpG can synergize. In this study, we gave low-dose radiation for 2 days at the beginning of the study, 5 weekly injections of intratumoral CpG and systemic ibrutinib starting at week 2. And we found that in the first 13 patients we've treated, we've had 7 patients achieve at least a partial response, and more than 75% of patients have achieved some distal tumor burden reduction, which is really encouraging given that ibrutinib monotherapy in this patient population has a response rate of about 20.9% in a large patient population. So we're encouraged by those results, but in addition, we have a lot of correlative studies where we're trying to learn more about how these therapies work in patients. And these include, or these are performed on fine needle aspirates from the tumor sites, both the directly injected tumor site and also a distant tumor site before and after treatment, as well as some peripheral blood. And those studies have been really interesting as well. We found an increase in CD4 effector T cells occurring after treatment, both in the injected and uninjected site in these first 13 patients. And interestingly, the amount of accumulation of these CD4 effector T cells by week 6 on the study seems to predict for distal tumor burden reduction. So we find that really promising and really interesting. We were also looking at immune response assays where we're culturing patients' tumor cells with their own T cells to see how well the T cells react or get activated by the tumor, and we're finding that T cells taken from pre-treatment versus post-treatment, the T cells after we've performed the treatment maneuvers are much more reactive to the patient's own tumor in a culture system, suggesting that we're inducing a tumor-specific immune response. So I think that's also very exciting.